गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू वंस अगेन.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
दिस इज डार्कनेस सर. वेलकम यू ऑल इन द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड द रोबोटिक्स. दिस इज अवर थर्ड लेक्चर एंड अप टिल वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंट कंसेप्ट लाइक व्हाट इज मीन बाय द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, वेरियस एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, हिस्ट्री ऑफ द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, एप्लीकेशंस, and also we have seen the relationship between the AI, ML and the deep learning. I hope all of you have got that concept. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, our today's session is on the overview of the machine learning and some of the basic algorithm related with the machine learning. Okay. Now, machine learning as a syllabic point is not there, but for your understanding purpose we need to understand the algorithms related with the machine learning so that the our further concept will become easy for your understanding. Okay, now let's start. Now you can see here this definition and the description already last time also we have discussed, but here just I have shown you on the right side, you can see the figure. I have shown the machine learning and the some of its related algorithms. Understood? Now in case of our exam point of view, we don't have any kind of algorithm related with the machine learning, but for the purpose of understanding I am explaining this part to you. Okay, now what is the machine learning concept? Last time I told you what is mean by the machine learning. Yes, anybody else? Naikode, Sonal?
Sir?
Yes, Sonal.
Machine can learn from expensive part of the current data.
Okay.
Is called machine learning.
Oh yes. Anybody else? Gotekar Shubhangi. Yes, Jasmine Sheikh.
Yes, sir.
What you understood the machine learning? What is mean by the machine learning? Fennel?
So, machine learning means it yes. Improves the automatically of device. Machine.
What it improves and how?
So it's a language of machine that to understand, machine can understand.
No. Final.
Sir, machine learning is the artificial intelligence जहाँ पे मशीन को एबिलिटी प्रोवाइड की जाती है कि वो खुद ना खुद चीजें इम्प्रूव कर सके उसके अंदर और चीजें लर्न भी कर सके एंड उसके अंदर एक्सप्लिसिट प्रोग्रामिंग किए बिना वो चीजें खुद अडेप्ट कर सकती है.
I last time I showed you the relationship between the artificial intelligence, machine learning and the deep learning. Yes. Yes. So artificial intelligence is the broader term. If you remember that figure I have shown you last time. So under the, you know, to make the artificial intelligence successful, we need the two important technology to be follow. One is that is the machine learning and another is which? Another is the
deep learning.
Okay. So machine here I already learning. I have written the definition.
Deep learning.
The machine learning is nothing but the subfield or the under the artificial intelligence. It is another branch related to the artificial intelligence that provide the system ability to automatically learn and improve from the experience. Understood? Now, related with the machine, experience is nothing but what? It's data. That is the data. Clear, all of you? Yes. So, there are the different kind of machine learning algorithms are there. Can you able to see this figure?
Yes, sir.
So, there are the various kind of machine learning algorithms are there. Okay. So, out of that, we are just going to see some of the basic, like here, I'm marking here. Let's see. I'm marking here like this one as an unsupervised learning. Can you able to see the mark?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Unsupervised learning. And second important one in that, the supervised
learning.
Okay. Now, before we go to that actual algorithm, we need to clear the one important point from here. That is nothing but what is mean by the without being explicitly programmed. What is mean by the without being explicitly programmed? Last time also we have discussed this point. Okay. Now with example, today we have taken one example, and that with the help of that example, we can make that concept clear. What exactly mean by the without explicitly program? In the definition of the machine learning, you can see in the last part, you can see improve from the previous experience without being explicitly programmed. Now, first we understand what is actually mean by the explicitly program. Okay. Explicitly program means what? Here in the bracket also I have mentioned the hard coding. Can you anybody able to tell me what is mean by the hard coding?
So it means it do the task automatically without any human intervention.
That is the hard coding you want to say. Rohini?
So hard coding means
yes.
Written.
Can't hear you properly, Rohini.
So, hello.
Ha, yes.
So hard coding means human la aplyala samajnar nahi, pan machine la samajnar nahi mhanje hard coding. Machine can understand but human cannot understand that language.
No. Yes, anybody else? Unmute the mic. Somebody's bike voice I'm hearing here. Yes. Fennel, what do you mean by the hard coding?
Hard coding means we cannot be altered or modified without modifying.
Exactly. Who is this?
Asma, sir.
Yes. Hard coding, last time also I tried to explain the example, means what? Suppose I told you to do the C program of addition of the two numbers. Now in that program, you have to write the each and every instruction for what? To display the number, to take the input from the user, etc., etc. Means what? For each particular action that you want to perform from the machine, for each and every action, you have to write the instruction. You are getting what I'm saying? For each and every action, you have to write the instruction. Here also I have mentioned writing out the instruction in order to accomplish a change manually is nothing but the explicit programming. Means what? Whatever action you want to be performed from the machine, for each action there is a need to write the machine, there is need to write the particular programming instruction. That is we are doing, like programming that we are doing in our academics. Understood? We have not seen up till the program related with the machine learning. Yes or no? You are getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
In our practicals also, we have seen whatever task you want to perform, for that particular task, we have to write an each and every instruction. You are getting what I'm saying? So, in case of the machine learning programming, there is a no need of such kind of things. Understood? What? There is a no need of such kind of things, and that's why it is being referred as without being explicitly programmed. Understood? Now, below in the second statement, I have mentioned no hard codings, means no need to write the specifically each and every instruction for the particular machine action. Machine action manje kay ata, just like when you are doing some program and you want to display some on the on your monitor screen. Now, in order to display something on your monitor screen, you need to write the instruction in your program or not? Hello?
Yes, sir. We have to write.
You have to write the particular instruction, na?
Yes, yes, sir.
In order to display something on the screen, in order to take the input from the user, that kind of things. Understood? But in case of the machine learning programming, for each and every action, there is a no need to write the programming language instruction. Understood? And that's why it is called as what? Without explicitly programmed. And that's why it is being referred as a no hard coding. Now, another, I have made it more simple by taking this example. See here, you can see the below strip. Okay, where I have mentioned a three instruction. Can you able to see all of you?
Yes, 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 sir.
So what I have written, string first name equal to hello world. Okay, first name is a variable. Then console write line first name. Then third string first name equal to console dot read line. Now, can anybody able to tell me what is the difference between the first instruction? What is the difference between the first instruction and the second instruction?
Sir, in first instruction, the value is directly assigned, and in second instruction, it is read from another.
Another, in the sense, it will be
user.
User, exactly. Who is this? Who said the
so
user?
Input.
Rohini.
Yes.
Rohini, you are not in the range. Okay. You said correctly. Now, if you observe this first statement, okay, this first statement, see, now in this first statement, every time if you want to change the value of first name, you have to make, you know, you have to make the change here. All of you are agree?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
But in case of the second statement, there is a no need to change in the value every time. Why? Do you understand what I am asking? In case of the first statement,
yes, sir,
you need to change this value every time.
Yes.
If you want to change the value of first name, correct?
Yes, sir.
But what is the case in case of the second statement? Is there any need to change the value every time?
No.
No, sir.
Because
no, sir,
you are taking the value from the user.
Yes, yes, sir.
Understood. Means in case of the first one, manually you have to do the changes.
Yes,
you are getting what I am saying. Manually you have to do the changes here in order to modify the value of first name, and that is called as what? The hard coding. Got the point?
Okay,
I am trying to simplify it. And in case of the second one, there is a no need to change the value because you are asking the value from the user. You are getting what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
You are asking the value from the user. No need to change the value every time. So that is being come under the category of what? No
hard code.
I hope you have got the difference between the explicit programming and without explicit programming. You got the point?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So that is now I'm going to make it more clear by taking the real life example. Now suppose when you are suppose you have joined the course of driving the car. Okay, you have joined the course of driving the car, and you learn driving by using that Maruti Suzuki car. usually the most of the school of that learning prefer. Correct?
Yes, sir.
You join the driving course and you learn the driving using that Maruti Suzuki car. Correct? You got the situation?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then, now you finish your course. You finish your course and your parents bring the Maruti's Swift car into your home. Maruti's Swift car. You are getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Can you able to drive the Maruti Swift car? Shubham?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Do you got the situation what I am saying?
Sir, explain again.
You learn the driving using which car?
Maruti.
The small car, correct? But your parents bring the Swift car, purchase the Swift car.
Yes.
What I am asking, will you be able to drive the Swift car?
Yes, sir, we can drive.
Yes, definitely you can drive. Correct?
Yes, yes sir.
After learning the driving course once, you can drive the truck also.
Yes, sir.
Yes, na. With some, yes. you need some practice, but you can definitely able to do that.
Yes, sir, of course.
Yes.
Of course. Means once you learn the driving, there is a no need to learn the driving for another vehicles like the Swift, truck, like that kind of things. Am I correct?
Yes, sir, correct.
Means what? Programming of your brain has happened how many times? Once or not?
Once.
Consider your programming of your brain has happened. Meaning of that, you learn the driving course. That is the. To that I am referring the programming of your brain happen. Correct?
Right, sir.
Right.
Yes,
so,
sir.
you learn the driving course for the Maruti 800 and after that, you can drive the any vehicle. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And that is nothing but the without being explicitly programming of your brain. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, if sir. If you need to join the driving course for the truck also, for another vehicle which is different from the Maruti car also, then that will come under the category of
explicit program.
I hope now all of you have got the concept. Ki explicit
yes,
program ani without being explicit. Yachyamadhye aata hi ji definition hai. Which definition? This is a previous definition. Now, most of the people are having the confusion in the particular part. That part is nothing but what? This part. You are getting. What exactly mean by the without being explicitly programmed? Manje asa aahe ka ki machine learning sati programming karavi lagat nahi? Asa aahe ka? Nahi, tasa nahi.
Nahi, nahi.
Yes, sir. Karavi lagte. Programming tar karavi lagte. But that hard coding is not required to be done.
Yes, sir. It understood. Work on past experiences.
Yes. Once it learns
yes.
initially, then it can modify itself. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Just
sir.
Like you, once you drive, learn the driving course. After that, if you try to drive the truck, you can make the changes in yourself. Yes or no? By yourself.
Yes, yes sir. Yes. Sir.
Or will you need that person who have taught you the driving? No, nah.
No.
No. Mm-hmm. Exactly. And so that example just come in my mind, and that's why I told you that example. Okay, I hope all of you got another example. I can tell you. Do you need another example, real life example?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir.
For example, when we are in the child age, manje ki mana 5-6 years, now our parents teach us. If some vehicle is coming from your right side or the left side of your road, are you with me, all of you?
Yes, yes, sir.
Our parents teach us if there is some vehicle coming from the left side or right side of your on the vehicle, that time you should not cross the road. Am I right?
Yes.
Sir.
But now if initially your parents taught you, suppose one bike is coming from your right side, that time your parent told you, now bike is coming, don't cross the road. Correct?
Yes.
Once your parent taught you this kind of situation, will there be the need in the future that your parents has to tell you, if truck is coming, if car is coming, if any vehicle is coming, don't cross the road? Is this kind of instruction will be need from your parents every time?
No, sir.
No. No. No, sir.
That is nothing but the without explicitly programming. Am I right?
Right. Yes, yes, sir.
I hope the concept is being clear. Okay.
Yes, sir.
This example is very good.
Yeah. Now let's see. Now that is the point I want to explain here. Now come to the our learning approach. Now, as initially I told you, two learning approaches are there. One is the supervised and another is the unsupervised. Here you can be able to see the basket. Okay, here you can be able to see this basket with some fruit. Okay, with some fruit. And what we have to do? We have to do the grouping of this fruit. Understand the thing? What we have to do? We have to do the grouping of the fruits which is being put in this basket. Here you can read. Suppose. Hello guys.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, we got disconnected because of the time limit. So we first learn about the supervised learning. Now we have given the basket and it is filled with the different kinds of fruits. And our task is what? We have to arrange them in the group. Understand the situation?
Yes, sir.
We have to arrange them as a group. Now, for understanding, let me clear you the name of the fruit also. I am telling you the name of the fruits. We have the apple. We have the apple. We have the banana. Okay. Then we have the grapes.
Grapes.
And yes, we have the cherry.
Cherry.
Orange.
Cherry. Okay.
Okay.
And now we have to arrange them in the group. Here you have to consider, you already know about these fruits. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then now, meaning of the my statement that you have already know about these fruits is what? You have some previous experience related with that. Am I right?
Right, sir.
Yes, sir.
You have some previous experience related with that. And that is the reason if I ask you to group these fruits in the different groups, you will be able to do that easily or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. How will you able to do that?
On the basis of past experience.
Yes.
Past experience in the sense means what?
Means to us we have explicitly, without explicitly programmed, as you gave the last example.
Yes, we understand that how that group we can do that from past.
How that is I am asking, how you can do the grouping of the fruits which is being contained in the basket. Okay.
Color. Color size.
Ah, exactly. Who said the
coloring
color?
Shapes.
Yes, means you already know about some of the physical characteristic of that fruit, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So that is the reason. Physical characteristic like what? If the apple come in front of you, you know it is the rounded shape, there is a notch in the between part of the apple, it is the red color, like that kind of things you would know, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yo.
Yes,
so
sir.
Your previous work is called as the training data, very important part. What? जी ज्या गोष्टी तुम्हाला ऑलरेडी माहित आहेत त्या फ्रूट बद्दल त्याला काय म्हणायचं ट्रेनिंग डेटा
ट्रेनिंग डेटा
यू ऑलरेडी ट्रेन अंडरस्टूड युअर प्रिव्हियस वर्क इज कॉल्ड एज अ ट्रेनिंग डेटा इन डेटा मायनिंग यू ऑलरेडी लर्न फ्रॉम द थिंग्स ओके सो दिस इज बिकॉज नाव दॅट्स वाय दॅट पर्टिक्युलर वी कॅन कॉल दॅट पर्टिक्युलर ट्रेन व्हेरिएबल एज अ रिस्पॉन्स व्हेरिएबल ऑल्सो कॅन वी एबल येस ऑर नो the things which you know as a train data can we call them as a response variable
yes sir
yes, yes because sir. it is giving us giving you the some kind of idea or you can call that's why you can call it yes. as the response variable or the
response variable
or the decision variable yes or no
yes sir
yes sir
yes,
yes sir
then now come to the next point so suppose you have taken a new fruit from the basket and then you will see the size color shape of that particular fruit yes or no what you will observe if you take the one fruit from the basket what first actually these things are happen within some microseconds in our brain yes or no but yes. what I am telling yes, you now what I am telling you now the inside part the inside processing which is happening in our brain without any kind of delay understood what happen in our brain the physical characteristic of that fruit comes like if you take the fruit from your size. basket if its size of that fruit is big if the color is red what if the size of that fruit is big color is red
big
shape is rounded red. shape
rounded shape
with, shape with depression at the top you will confirm the fruit name as what it is the which apple. kind of fruit
apple.
The, apple
apple understood yes. and you will put yes. that you will put that fruit in which group apple group
apple.
yes or no
apple group
likewise
yes, sir.
likewise you will do it for the other fruit also
yes sir
and accordingly yes, sir. you can do the grouping of the fruits
yes sir
correct exactly. you can group all the fruits according to this if yes, the size if the size is small color is red heart shape to the nearby globular that kind of fruit is what cherry the size cherry. is big color is green long curving cylinder the name of the fruit is what
banana.
If the size is small color is green round to the oval bunch shape cylindrical that fruit name is what
grapes.
So that is nothing but the job of grouping this particular grouping is called as the technical name for this kind of grouping is called as the classification what it is called as what
classification
this kind of group is called grouping is called as what classification now do you feel any kind of difficulty in grouping this kind of way
no
because you already have some kind of knowledge about that kind of fruits that's why you don't feel any kind
yes.
of you don't feel any kind of difficulty
okay yes.
So you can observe in the table also that fruit column was labeled as a fruit name. This is called as a, this all being referred as a response variable. If you learn the thing before from the training data, so the things which you already know that you are referring was a training data, correct? The thing which you already know before, we can call it as a training data or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, and, sir.
And applying that training data, what? applying that training data to some new fruit understand the situation applying that training data
yes sir
to some new fruit
no fruits
that yes. that particular kind of thing is called as what that kind of data you can call as what that kind of data
is data
exactly that kind of data you can call what that kind of data you can call as a
knowledge to the test data
test data
understood just like I told you ki apli task kay hoti aplyala bucket madhe fruit identify karaychi hoti barobar so you can do it easily because you have some past experience related with that data so that past experience related with that fruit is nothing but the training data understood and you are applying that knowledge to the new data yes or no
yes sir
yes sir
when you are applying that knowledge to the new data, that new data is nothing but your which kind of data? Test data.
Test data.
I hope you have got the two terms, the training data and the
test data.
The things which are already known, that is considered as the training data, and the new things comes in front of you, and if you apply your previous knowledge on that new things, that new thing is called as which kind of data? Test data. Understood?
Test data.
This kind of learning is called as what? The supervised learning.
Supervised learning.
Got the point? This kind of learning is called as what?
Supervised learning.
All of you learning. Got the concept?
Yes, sir.
And this particular grouping comes under the technique that is called as what? The classification.
Classification.
Understood? That is being referred as the classification. Okay. So all of you got the supervised learning?
Yes, sir.
All of you got the supervised learning?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now come to the next point. That is the unsupervised learning. We apply the same example here also. Suppose you have a basket and it is filled with the different types of the fruits. Your task is to arrange them as a group. Same task we have to perform. Correct?
Yes.
Here you can observe this figure. We can observe this figure also gives you the idea about what we have discussed now. Correct?
Yes, sir.
This is the supervised and below is the example of unsupervised. Input data means what?
Apple.
That has to be tested. Apple. That has to be tested. Annotation manje kay? Train. That already you know. Ki tumhala already maithe ki ha is being understood. Mag,
yes.
Machine learning la kasa, how the machine learning model identify this, that is being shown here. Okay. So machine learning model, this is being considered the machine learning model, like our brain. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So machine has, so in case of the supervised learning, machine has to give the training first. Ki if the size of the particular fruit is large, it is color red, like that kind of things, then the prediction should happen like this. Ki it is an apple.
Okay.
Now come to the next point. That is the point of the unsupervised learning. Suppose you have a basket and it is full with etc. etc. This time you have to imagine. Okay, guys, this time you have to imagine. You don't know anything about the fruits.
Okay,
this is important statement. What you have to imagine? You don't know anything about the fruits. Ki apple ka hai, cherry ka hai, banana ka hai. You don't have any clue about this. Now, how you will arrange them and what you will do first?
Physical character.
Size, color.
So what will happen? You will consider about the physical character of that particular fruit.
Fruits.
What you will think? You will think about the physical character of that fruit. And now let's see further. Suppose you have considered first physical character, you have considered as a color. What?
Color.
Then you will arrange them on consider on the basis of the color, and accordingly the group will form. Correct? So according to the first characteristic, let's see how the group is forming. Red color group. Here you can see. Can you able to see? Red color group.
Yes, sir.
Red color group. Mag red color group madhe kutle, which fruits will come under the red color group?
Apple and cherry.
Definitely apple and the
apple
cherry.
And cherry.
Then you have to keep in mind in front of your eyes there must be that basket containing the four fruits.
Yes.
Apple, cherry, grapes, and banana. Then Next color. Is there any next Gray. Color available in the basket fruits? Yes.
Yes.
What is that next color? Green.
Green. Green color.
Then, according to this color, which fruits can be put in this group?
Banana and grapes.
Banana and the grapes. Grapes. Now, some of you might be, some of you can say here ki, black grapes are also there. Like you have to consider about them. Only the green
sir,
grapes.
Banana is yellow, na?
Banana is yellow.
Banana is yellow.
No, no, no. Banana. Yes, here you can see it is yellow. But if it is not ripe completely, it can also come under the category of. It can come under the category of green. Okay.
Green.
Yes, yes.
For the sake of example, yes. Yes, you are correct. Yes, it is being. We are looking at it as a yellow, but we have to form the group. Yes or no?
So I can understand, sir. Yes. We can understand.
Yes. So here you have to consider the kaccha banana. Correct. Yes. So that remaining two fruits will come under the category of green color group, and green accordingly color. The two groups will be formed. One is the red color, another is the green color.
Green color.
So
green
according color. To the first characteristic. According to the first physical characteristic, we have formed the two groups. Correct? Now we can apply.
Yes, sir.
Again.
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So first, according to the first character, what first characteristic we have taken? The color. Now let's move forward, and now we'll take the another physical characteristic as a size. Yes. We'll take the another physical characteristic as a size here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And
yes, sir.
Now we'll combine that two characteristics. Which two characteristics? First, we have seen the color, and now we are looking at the size. Correct.
Color.
Now we form the group like yes. Red color and the big size. Correct. Size can be a here. Yes. Size can be a big or small one. Two things. Yes.
Yes.
Red color and big size.
Big size.
So under the red color and big size, which fruit come? Apple.
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 Then red color and the small size, which fruits would come?
Cherry.
Cherry. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Green color. Cherry. Big size. Banana.
Banana. Banana.
Color. Small size. Grapes.
Grapes. Grapes.
So our job is done. Happy ending. Yes or no?
Yes,
sir.
You didn't know anything. Still you have done the grouping or not?
Yes, yes sir.
All of you got the situation.
Yes, sir.
We didn't know yes. anything. We didn't know anything. Still we able to group the. We able to group the fruits.
Yes.
And this kind of grouping is called as the clustering.
Clustering.
Okay, this kind of grouping is called as what?
Clustering.
And this kind of learning is called as what?
Unsupervised
learning.
Concept clear?
Learning.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and so likewise, there are still more algorithms related with the machine learning. But we don't have to do with that now in this subject. I just want to, these are the two popular, under this supervised and the unsupervised, other algorithms also fall. Okay, another algorithm also come under the supervised learning also and the unsupervised. Understood. So in the similar way,
yes,
machine also learn using the supervised learning also and using the unsupervised learning also.
Unsupervised learning also.
Just like us as a human yes, being, sir. Just like us as a human being, learning as a supervised, also as a unsupervised, the same concept is applied to the machine also. Got the two learning approaches, supervised learning and the
yes.
unsupervised learning approach. Any doubt in the today's session?
No, no, sir.
Concept clear zali kuni. Can anybody able to tell me then the real life example of supervised learning? most of the things we learn comes under the supervise. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
जसं मी मगाशी तुम्हाला रोड क्रॉसिंग आय टोल्ड यू द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ रोड क्रॉसिंग समबडी हॅज सुपरवाइज ऑन यू एम आय राईट समबडी हॅज ऑलरेडी टॉट यू की बाईक इज कमिंग फ्रॉम युअर साईड ऑन द एनी ऑफ द लेफ्ट साईड ऑर द राईट साईड यू मस्ट नॉट क्रॉस द रोड समबडी हॅज ऑलरेडी टॉट यू
राईट येस सर
एम आय राईट समबडी हॅज सुपरवाइज ऑन यू
येस सर
दॅट इज द सुपरवाइज देन इफ यू लर्न समथिंग विदाउट the supervision of anybody if you learn something without the supervision of anybody then that become the unsupervised learning for example yes anybody can I get the example from you unsupervised learning
सर जसं की आपण समजा शिक्षक जर वर्गात आले तर आपण गुड मॉर्निंग करतो आपण लहानपणापासून शिकत आलेलो
हा पण कधीतरी आपल्याला एलकेजी युकेजी मध्ये सांगितलं
सांगितलेलं असणार आहे सरांनी
की शिक्षकांनंतर उभं राहायचं बरोबर ना यू ट्राईड इट बिकॉज यू नो टू फाइंड द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग इट इज डिफिकल्ट स्टील आय कॅन ट्राय सम पीपल यूज टू डू द कॉपी इन द एक्झाम एम आय राईट
Yes, sir.
How to do the copy, I don't think anybody has to tell you.
Even anybody tells you,
student able to find out their own strategies. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So that we can consider as unsupervised learning.
Unsupervised, right. Perfect example.
So that is the end of today's session. Here I have the one quote for you today. You are stronger than you think. So
yes.
Take the efforts.